Hi everyone, the Lone Wolf here, and yes, I'm once again mining. I apologize for the boring footage lately, but there are a lot of changes in the pipeline, presumably for the next Inferno patch in August, and some of these are very important for the stuff that I do, which is mostly mining, industrial activities and things like that. At the same time, I'm training for a Drake, which is a decent PvP ship, not great but pretty cheap for what it does. And so yeah, I'm doing a lot of mining, trying to get some ISK together, and we'll see if I get some PvP going later on. But in this video, what I wanted to talk about are the changes that are on CC now about the mining barges. I haven't seen a dev blog on it yet, but someone took a look at it on CC and has made several posts on it about it on the forum. So let me just go over on the other screen and have a look at his findings. Now keep in mind, these are changes on the test server, so there is no guarantee that these changes will also come in the exact same numbers on the live servers on TQ, but I think we can get a general idea of what CCP is planning to achieve with these changes. So let's start with probably the most important to a lot of miners. That's the mining yields of all the main mining ships. So the baseline is still the Hulk. That one will still have the mining yield. But compared to that, the Coveter will have 90.7% mining yield of what the Hulk can do with max skills and max slots in order to increase the mining yield. But after that, the Machina and the Retriever, which are the let's have a quick look, which are the two mining vessels that can field two strip miners, like this is the Retriever, for example. These get let me have a quick look here. Retriever 75.6% and a Machina 79.4% of the maximum yield that would be a Hulk. And then after that we have the Skiff and the Procurer, which are two mining vessels that can only field one strip miner, but so these were pretty useless before the patch, but right now on CC they will get let me see, the Procurer 75.6% mining yield, so the same as a Retriever, and then the Skiff also 79.4%, so the same as a Machina. So all these vessels will now yield around 90, 80, or 75% of what a Hulk can yield. On top of that, the real big change are the new cargo capacities. So the Hulk will have 500 normal cargo. These are base numbers, so without any rigs or low slots cargo enhancers. And the Hulk, 500 normal and 7500 for ore bay capacity. And then the Machina, this is like the major change, 350 normal and 25,000 ore bay capacity. That's enormous. The Skiff, that is just one mining laser or strip miner, is 350 normal, 17,500 ore bay capacity. Then the Coveter is once again similar to the Hulk, 507,000. The Retriever, 20,000 ore bay capacity. And then the Procurer, 15,000 ore bay capacity once again. So the idea here is that the Hulk and the Coveter, which can have the highest yield with three strip miners, have the lowest ore bay capacity. So clearly these are meant to be used in fleets where other people will hold the ore for you. At the same time, the Machina and the Retriever get very large ore bay capacities, 25,000 and 20,000. I mean, you could probably mine for almost an hour with these ships without having to go back to the station. And then finally, the Skiff and the Procurer, 15,000, 17,500. It's almost three times, it's more than three times what the Hulk and the Coveter can do. So they're still good for solo, but the the main thing that these guys get as a bonus are the their actual HP. So the Hulk and the Coveter, I would say these shield armor and structure hit points are 2500, 1800, 2000 or 2500, 2300, 2700, something like that. So if I count all those up, maybe around, let me see, 7500 hit points, somewhere around that, maybe even only 6000 for the Coveter, so very weak ship. The Mackinaw gets about double that, but then the Mackinaw and the Retriever, you know, about double that. But then the Skiff and the Procure get, I would say, around 3 times the EHP that the Hulk and the Coveter get. So the that's very interesting, and we'll have to wait and see if these changes effectively come like this, in these exact numbers on TQ. But the main design philosophy is pretty obvious. The Hulk and the Coveter, which the Hulk being the really the high-end mining fleet ship. So both the Hulk and the Coveter are meant to be used in mining fleets with Orca support and with people hauling for you. The Mackinaw and the Retriever, they get a lower yield but massive ore holes and not that much extra tank compared to the Hulk and the Coveter, about twice. So these are clearly the solo miners for high sec, you know, the guys that want to play it safe. They can go out and mine for a very long time, fill their ore and go back to the station without having to worry about too much stuff. And then the Skiff and the Procure, these will be your nullsec solo miners, basically. Although their yields are even lower than a Mackinaw, same with the Drone Bay, they have a massive tank with the right rigs and slots and stuff. I'm pretty sure you can make these very, very difficult to break. And I'm a bit surprised at how close all the yields are. You know, the Hulk being 100%, the baseline, the Mackinaw gets like almost 80% yield of what the Hulk can do. And if you then keep in mind that the Hulk has, what is it, only 1/4 the ore bay of the Mackinaw. Yeah, if like what I'm doing now in the Hulk, you know, I'm filling up my ore bay and then my cargo bay, I don't have an ore bay yet, and then I'm heading back to the station in order to put the ore there, and I'm coming back with 80%. The Mackinaw is definitely the new choice in order to do some solo mining. I mean, the Hulk's capacity becomes pretty damn small, and yeah, that makes the travel time basically is going to be so punishing compared to the Mackinaw that it makes no sense taking out the Hulk solo anymore. You want that Mackinaw because of the massive ore bay. If you get half an hour, 1 hour, you can just go ahead, mine a number of asteroids and then get back to the station whenever you're done. But you'll hardly need more than 1 or 2 trips in order to mine for a few hours in a Mackinaw. So yeah, those are interesting changes for miners, I think. I'm expecting a dev blog on it relatively soon, since everything has already been basically checked out on CC and posted on the forums by now. We'll have to see, of course, when this gets deployed and what the exact numbers will be, but the design philosophy is clear. The big mining ships will get very little tank, and you want those only in fleets. Then there are some specific ships where you can be the very lazy miner, which I often am, and that's the Mackinaw and the Retriever for you. And there is a ship specifically for high risk 00 or low sec mining, probably very good for those high value asteroids that you can take out in 00 in the Skiff and the Procure, because they'll be able to field a massive tank compared to any mining ship at the moment. It's really going to be a major change. This could spell the end of Hulkageddon, you know. Any smart player will have a nicely tanked Mackinaw or Retriever, and that will be very hard to break. So these are the changes to the mining ships. Pretty important to me, pretty important for the baseline economy in EVE Online, in my opinion. And I'll see you guys next time.